guys, welcome to Books and Key and welcome to the bed rest edition. I am sitting in bed with a hot water bottle because of a bad back, but I did not want to miss out on making this video at the end of the year because I'm going to be talking about my top 5 audiobooks of 2020. Now, I've already done top 5 books, but I feel like audiobooks are a slightly different experience because you're not reading the book, you're having the book told to you, narrated to you. And so that's a much more immersive experience, I feel. So I decided that while I did my top 5 physical books, I would definitely make a separate video about audiobooks. So let's get started. The first audiobook I want to talk about is Pride and Prejudice. I listened to this on Audible. I think it's an Audible special. So this is a classic. And for those of you who don't know the story, this is the story of a lady named Mrs. Bennett. She has 5 daughters and her main objective in life is to get them married. And one of her daughters is the very headstrong Elizabeth Bennett. And then this new guy, Mr. Darcy, who seems very, very snobby because he's very, very wealthy, moves into the neighborhood and then they're at loggerheads. There is banter between them. There is tension between them. So it's kind of a hate to love story. I don't want to give anything else away, but I do feel like people already know enough about this story. If you feel intimidated by classics, definitely give this one a try on audio. The second book I want to talk about is Young Adult. It is With the Fire on High by Elizabeth Acevedo. Again, I listened to this on Audible and it is narrated by the author. And I think author-narrated audiobooks are so good because they're reading out their own work. They know what emotions to pour into it, what voices to use, how they want to tell the story. So I highly recommend that if you come across an audiobook that is narrated by the author, go for it. So this is the story of a young girl who dreams of becoming a chef. She's already a very, very good cook and she's able to, you know, use ingredients in different ways, identify ingredients and spices and herbs in different dishes. And so she is really, really on top of her game when it comes to food and cooking. But she also is a teen mother. She has a daughter and she and her mother are taking care of this baby. So she has to kind of balance between her aspirations of wanting to be a chef and the reality of being a single parent. I really, really enjoyed this book. There's not a lot of angst and this thing. The girl is very, very determined and she really makes the most of her circumstances despite the fact that they are very difficult. Highly recommend. Speaking of author-narrated audiobooks, my third book is Know My Name by Chanel Miller. This was a very difficult read. Chanel Miller is the victim in the Brock Turner rape case. She was raped by this guy and everyone kind of seemed to focus on Brock Turner rather than her. And even I remember reading the newspaper about how Brock Turner was a really nice guy and very good at swimming and he could have been in the Olympics. So I think people took him a lot more seriously. And then Chanel Miller decided to talk out. She first did an essay, I think, online, talking out and kind of revealing her name. And then she's written this book and she's reading it out to you and it is painful. She talks about the actual assault. Then she talks about her legal struggles, judgment by the media, you know, dealing with friends and family, the full thing. And I think reading about this experience from her point of view was so hard and so difficult, but also so empowering because she actually has the courage to stand up and tell her own story. This one made me cry. You must listen to it. And if I did not mention it already, I listened to this on Audible. The fourth audiobook I want to talk to you about is a middle grade novel. It is Coraline by Neil Gaiman and I listened to this on Scribd. It is narrated by Neil Gaiman, which in itself is a fabulous recommendation because he does it so, so well. This is the story of a young girl named Coraline who suddenly walks through a doorway in her house and finds herself in this alternate universe. It mirrors the world that she lived in, except that it's slightly creepier and darker, and her parents have buttons for eyes. And these button-eyed parents want to keep her in the creepy alternate universe and she wants to go back to her own world. There are a lot of songs and rhymes and that kind of thing in this book. And Neil Gaiman does the creepy songs so well. even though this is a middle grade novel, I highly recommend that you listen to it because it cannot and should not be missed. Last book, we have The House on the Cerulean Sea. This is not narrated by the author. I listened to it on Scribd, but the narrator did a fabulous job, and I'll tell you why. Because this is the story of a man named Linus Baker who is sent to kind of oversee this orphanage where there are six magical children. One of them is a gnome, I think one of them is some kind of forest creature, and then there is Lucy, who is the son of Satan, literally. So going there kind of opens up his mind, it gives him different perspectives on life, it kind of helps change his way of thinking, and I think ultimately it changes his life. The narrator does so well with the voices for the children, especially Lucy, with the voice for Linus Baker, kind of showing him initially as an uptight guy, and then as he loosens up and changes his perspective. He also makes an amazing voice for Arthur, who is the caretaker of the orphanage. So highly, highly, highly recommend. My favorite of the five, I think, would be Know My Name. Because it is really hard hitting, and I think everyone, especially every woman, should give it a listen. Also, if you aren't on the audiobook train already, I hope this video has inspired you, because they are an amazing way of listening to books when you don't have access or the ability to read a physical book. Say you're in bed and your spouse is asleep or your kids are asleep and you want to read but you can't turn on the light. Say you're doing chores, you're taking a walk. It is an amazing way to get in reading without actually sitting down and reading. And the audiobook apps that I use are Audible, Scribd, and now I've recently used Storytel, and that's pretty good as well. Although the book selection is not that great. So yeah, those were my top 5 audiobooks of the year. And let me know in the comments below if you like audiobooks and what your favorite audiobooks are, because I'm always looking for recommendations. Thank you so much for watching, guys. I hope you enjoyed this video despite the change in location, and I will see you in my next video. Bye.